If you like this, please share it.
I was on the outskirts of a little southern town, trying to reach my destination before the sun went down. The old CB was blaring away on channel 19 when there came a little boy's voice on the radio line. And he said, "Breaker 19, is anyone there? Come on back, truckers, and talk to Teddy Bear." Well, I keyed the mic and I said, "You got it, Teddy Bear." And the little boy's voice came back on the air. "Appreciate the break. Who we got on that end?" Well, I told him my name, and then he began. "Now, I'm not supposed to bother you fellas out there. Mom says you're busy, and for me to stay off the air. But you see, I get lonely, and it helps to talk. 'Cause that's about all I can do. I'm crippled, and I can't walk." I came back and told him to foreign that mic, and I talked to him as long as he liked. "This was my dad's radio," the little boy said, "but I guess it's mine and Mom's now, 'cause my daddy's dead. Dad had a wreck about a month ago. He was trying to get home in the blinding snow. Mom has to work now to make ends meet, and I'm not much help with my two crippled feet. She says not to worry, we'll make it all right. But I hear her crying sometimes late at night. You know, there's one thing I want more than anything else to see. Oh, I know you guys are too busy to bother with me. But you see, my dad used to take me for rides when he was home. But I guess that's all over now, since my daddy's gone." Not one breaker came on the old CB as that little cripple boy talked with me. I tried hard to swallow a lump that just wouldn't stay down, 'cause I thought about my boy back in Greenville town. Dad was gonna take Mom and me with him later on this year. Well, I remember him saying, "Someday this old truck'll be yours, Teddy Bear." But I know I'll never get to ride an 18-wheeler again. But this old base will help me keep in touch with all my trucker friends. Teddy Bear's gonna back on out now and leave you alone, 'cause it's about time for Mom to come home. But you give me a shout when you're passing through, and I'll sure be happy to come back to you. Well, I came back and I said, "Before you go, 1010, what's your home 20, little CB friend?" Well, he gave me his address, and I didn't once hesitate, 'cause this hot load of freight is just gonna have to wait. I turned that truck around on a dime and headed straight for Jackson Street, 229. And as I rounded the corner, oh, I got one heck of a shock. 18-wheelers were lined up for 3 city blocks. Why, I guess every driver for miles around had caught Teddy Bear's call, and that little cripple boy was having a ball. For as fast as one driver would carry him in, another would carry him to his truck and take off again. Well, you better believe I took my turn at riding Teddy Bear. And then I carried him back in and put him down in his chair. And buddy, if I never live to see happiness again, I want you to know I saw it that day in the face of that little man. We took up a collection for him before his mama got home, and each driver said goodbye, and then they were all gone. He shook my hand with a mile-long grin and said, "So long, trucker, I'll catch you again." Yeah, I hit that interstate with tears in my eyes, and I turned on the radio and I got another surprise. "Breaker 19," came a voice on the air. "Just one word of thanks from Mama Teddy Bear. We wish each and every one a special prayer for you, 'cause you just made my little boy's dream come true. I'll sign off now before I start to cry. May God ride with you. 10-4 and goodbye."
Thank you so much for listening.
Share this. If you want to share it, that would be awesome.